Okay, now that rescue mission that's happening now in Africa, here's what happened. An American tourist went down to safari in eastern Africa, in Uganda, a wildlife safari there. Here's the spot on the map. And somebody stole her, basically. That's the word from Ugandan officials who say gunmen ambushed her tour group's vehicle in a national park. They're just tooling along, and poof, in they come, snatch her up. She's 35 years old. She was with other tourists, but the gunman left all the other tourists alone and took her and the African guide and snatched them away. The spot is Queen Elizabeth National Park. It's one of the most famous wildlife reserves in all of the continent of Africa, and a very popular place for tourists to see lions and hippos. And that's where all of this is unfolding. Our national security correspondent, Jennifer Griffin's on it. She's live at the Pentagon. This is a crazy story, Jennifer.
It really is, Shepard, and we've just received a statement from the State Department saying, quote, "We are aware of reports of a U.S. citizen kidnapped in Uganda. Security forces are responding to the incident. We have no further information to offer at this time." The American tourist was stopped, as you mentioned, with her safari group at gunpoint in the Queen Elizabeth National Park, a popular safari area in southwest Uganda on the border with Congo. She and her driver were taken away by four gunmen who later used their phone to call in a $500,000 ransom demand. The U.S., unlike some countries, does not pay ransoms. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo said as much yesterday.
"Please remember that any payment to a terrorist or a terrorist regime gives money so that they can seize more of our people. We cannot accept that risk. You wouldn't ask that of us. Even a small payment to a group in, say, Africa can facilitate the killing or seizure of tens or even hundreds of others, including Americans."
A haunting foreshadowing of today's events. There are about 20 American ships held in captivity overseas right now. Shepard?
That's total. But do we have an idea yet, Jennifer? Do you know why this particular woman, like, on safari in Uganda, it's so out of the world?
Well, it's really unusual. American tourists traveling in Africa are an unusual target. Americans usually travel to Uganda to see gorillas. This attack took place in Queen Elizabeth National Park, which is a more traditional safari site. Uganda shares a border with Kenya, which has been the target of multiple terror attacks targeting foreigners. Spillover, of course, from the U.S. and African effort to combat al-Qaeda-linked al-Shabaab in Somalia. But this part of Uganda is closer to the Democratic Republic of Congo, which has been in the throes of a vicious civil war for decades. Four other tourists, as you mentioned, were part of that safari group. They were left behind by the kidnappers. The Ugandan police issued the following statement: "We strongly believe this ransom is the reason behind the kidnap. Their vehicle was left parked, and the kidnappers went away with the key. The Ugandan police have sent an elite squad to pursue the kidnappers." We'll have more when we get more from that area, Shepard.
All right, Jennifer. Jennifer Griffin, thanks so much.